In this video, we're going to take a look at the dungeons in Wind Waker. Overall, there isn't that many good dungeons you can find in this game. Some dungeons were really well made, while some could have been better. We're the owners of Triforce, I'm owner too, and this is our Wind Waker dungeons ranking. Well, this dungeon isn't pretty special. A normal forest dungeon, if you ask us. But it does look pretty, we'll give it that. It really looks like you're inside of a tree, where grass and many other plants are growing. Still, this isn't really something special. It isn't really funny. Actually, it's pretty boring. I, for one, find the music to be pretty fitting to the dungeon. But both that and that it looks pretty is the only plus we can give it. It's got some puzzles to do with wind. Oh, and it got one of the weirdest enemies in it. Yes, the pooping butterfly called Mothla. So, you're inside a giant volcano. First of all, how do you survive in here? Isn't it really hot? Well, cool dungeon, it really is. As I said, volcano-like, and it really shows how a volcano looks like inside. There's lava, fire-elemented enemies, and so on. But you're just not inside this volcano all the time. You're actually outdoors sometimes too, which is pretty cool. It's the first dungeon, so we can't really expect anything difficult. So, as usual, the first dungeon ends up close to the bottom. Most people say this dungeon is really irritating, but I would say otherwise. It isn't really that irritating as most people say, but it may be a little stressful to babysit my car all the time. There are some puzzles which are really, I wouldn't say annoying, but more like tiring. The one where you have to use your iron boots to break parts of the floor to make a chest appear is tedious as hell. The puzzle is unlike something we've usually seen in the series. You have to break through all of these parts to get the chest, but how would you know that in the first place? It's okay when you really have to think, but in addition, you have to go down, bounce up, go down, bounce up, and so on and so on. It's got some puzzles with wind, as the dungeon name suggests, but it falls a bit short anyway. To us, it's not the worst dungeon in the game, but it's not as bad of a dungeon that many others think it is. This place is actually pretty cool. The first time you visit this dungeon, it's like a stealth mission. You have to defeat the enemies using the spotlights around Forsaken Fortress to proceed onto the dungeon. You're using barrels that are around the dungeon to hide from the moblins who patrols the dungeon. If you get caught by this, you're thrown into a prison cell. We like how you have to kill the bokoblins that use the searchlights to get the sword back, and make your way to the cell where Link's sister is. What's kinda lame is that the fortress is pretty empty. It's got a good size, but there's not much to find inside. This can be annoying since you have to get around without getting noticed by any moblins or searchlights. It's about the very first thing you do in the game, so you can't really have that high expectations. You have to visit this dungeon twice, but the second time you're there, it isn't that threatening, since you got more items, your sword, and your shield. And this time, it feels even emptier. They just threw in Phantom Ganon and the Skullhammer, which you have to use to smash down these blocks. You don't have to sneak around anymore, but you can kill the guards that are around. It's not really that much of a change, and you still have to go around the same areas, where there really aren't any new rooms to explore or anything. Overall, pretty cool dungeon, but it gets a little minus for the second time you're there. Tower of Gods is a huge tower, which most likely is why it's called Tower of Gods. The lowest level of this tower is filled with water, so you have to use your boat to get around here, which is pretty cool. The design in this dungeon is awesome, it really makes you feel like you're inside a temple. It really does feel like it belongs to some gods, and the music helps to make that feeling even greater. Also, the architecture is cool, and everything inside here looks good. It's got many good puzzles. There's a lot of platforming, and you have to use your bow, bombs, and good timing with the water level that changes. There's also a really good puzzle inside here, where you have to move three statues to the middle of the room to get further up into the dungeon. You can either carry them or control them yourself. Each of them has a different way to get it through. The one we had the most trouble with was to figure out how to get past these lasers, and we ended up doing this. You gotta use your brain at some places here. A good dungeon with, of course, a cool boss, Godan. Earth Temple is a little bit like the Shadow Temple from Ocarina of Time. Creepy, scary, dark, and overall a twisted dungeon. Good atmosphere and really cool. The enemies in here fit the dungeon very well. You got Poes, Stalfos, Floormasters, Bubbles, and of course, our second coolest enemies in the game, Redeads, inside coffins. Good puzzles where Medley is a good helper. You use her to fly and reflect the light with her harp. Later on you get the mirror shield and can reflect these lights yourself, but Medley is really helpful in this dungeon before that, and even with a few puzzles later where you both are needed to reflect light. The puzzles are usually about reflecting light here, to get chests to appear, to kill enemies, to remove walls and these weird elephants. The annoying thing about this dungeon is when you have to play the song to control Medley, which you have to play very often. There aren't that many rooms that don't require Medley's help, so you might get really tired of playing it, like we did. But all in all, we think this is the second best dungeon in Wind Waker. First of all, awesome dungeon, which is why it is the number one spot. It starts off like a volcano, where you have to fight the four bosses again, which is really cool. The fact that it's a bit like Ganon's Tower from Ocarina of Time, where the rooms you have to go through has something to do with the dungeons you've been in before, is awesome. It's not only the bosses that is from the dungeons, but it's also got something to do with the four of the dungeons you've been through. After you've gone through these dungeons, you come over a room which you have to do a puzzle where you fight Phantom Ganon. After you defeat Phantom Ganon, his blade will point in a direction which is the way you have to go to proceed into the dungeon. After this, you stumble upon a corridor with stairs, where you have to fight Darknuts to be able to proceed. After all this awesomeness, you finally meet the Puppet Ganons, and afterwards, Ganondorf. We really like how you visit parts of the dungeon that resemble earlier dungeons in the game, like you've said in dungeon rankings before this. This dungeon just reeks awesomeness, which is why it is our number one spot. That's it for our Wind Waker dungeon ranking. Some cool dungeons, some boring dungeons. What did you think about our list? Did you like it? Press that like button. Do you have your own list or want to comment on our choices? Leave a comment. Be sure to subscribe to our channel because there are more dungeons we have to go through. Thanks for watching.